see. I don't recognize you. I don't recognize your name or your face. Are you a celestial? You can't be. Are you human? Really? Oh, you're serious. Interesting. I apologize. Would you mind if I took a closer look at you? I haven't seen a human up close in a long, long time. Let me see. Okay, so your features there. Normal, I suppose, for a human. Anyway. Well, it's lovely to meet you, human. I'm Leo. You may be familiar with the Zodiacs. Yes, well, you could call me one of those. Refer to me however you'd like. God, celestial. Of stars that has somehow created its own consciousness and form. Of course, I am much older than you and have been conscious for a long, long time, so I suppose whatever you wish to think of me as, you may do so. I can't help what you think, but a little reference would be appropriate here. So tell me, were you born under my star sign? Interesting. Well, regardless, I am glad that you have come here. It gets kind of boring sometimes, just the same old thing happening. Of course, I pay attention to those humans who are born under my stars simply because they represent me. Well, I put a little piece of myself with them when they incarnate. It's, you know, a whole thing. It's a celestial job, I suppose. But, you know, you wouldn't know much about that. Which reminds me, how did you end up in the domain of Leo, anyway? Oh, you awoke in Cancer's domain. I see. And they sent you where? Here? You'd think they would have returned you to your home plane. An interesting mystery. Perhaps meeting me was part of your journey somehow. I'll have to have a conversation with the higher-ups about this, because I feel like this is illegal somehow in the rules of the universe, but who knows? The universe is infinite and endless, and there are often exceptions to things that, you know, we wouldn't have fathomed at one point in time. You are a lovely subject as well. For a human, you have quite pleasant features. Perhaps I'm just used to seeing the same people every day, but, you know, I haven't had the pleasure of incarnating as human myself in many years. More time than I think you could even fathom in your current state, that is. Well, suppose I should treat you sort of like people, right? You must be here for a reason. I should teach you whatever it is you can learn from me. How does that sound? Well, to start with, I think what we should do is tend to those wounds on your face. Yes, it seems you've taken quite a tumble. The forest and jungle and entire atmosphere of this land is a bit intimidating to those who are unfamiliar. It's, how do I put it, rather dangerous for those of mortal ilk. Which is why I'm surprised Cancer sent you here. Usually they're a pretty gentle soul. It looks like you needed to do some soul searching. Some soul searching. That's why you're here, isn't it? Oh, I knew it. Alright. First things first, I'm going to apply this healing salve to your wounds. Because it looks like you're going to need some help with healing that. I'm not used to if you're even here physically, or if this is just your astral form. Seems pretty physical, though. But then again, I've been fooled before. All this potion will do is numb those wounds. Numb those wounds. The physical body and even the soul can take some damage when traveling to planes without supervision. Hopefully, Cancer is watching over you, was watching over you in your travel here. But there are some things that even we can't control. Sorry if I'm getting a little too close. Like I said, I'm very excited by your presence here. Very excited to meet you. Let's just take a little moment. Can you think of any reason in your mortal life why you might be visiting me? You need, some more bravery in your life. Some more boldness, some more pride. Do you often struggle with insecurity, fear of the unknown, anxiety about others might think, or the consequences of your actions. My philosophy is to simply let those things go. Simply let it go. Let it fly away. And be confident in your choices. Of course, be wise. But if someone thinks ill of you, has nothing to do with you. I learned many millennia ago that you cannot control what other people think of you. But you can control what you think of yourself. And you know what people love? Confidence. False confidence has gotten many humans to big, grandiose spots in their life that, you know, make them feel accomplished, make people respect them. But when the confidence is real, when it's real, it's impervious. It's perfect. It's fulfilling. What do you think of that? Pretty good advice, right? I'm known for that, being amazing at giving advice and pretty much everything else I do. There's a reason that I'm, you know, one of many constellations, simply because if everything were just up to me, everybody would be really conceited and annoying, which, you know, to be fair, is kind of where a lot of people are headed. But you can see why I have to be kept in line, in balance, just like everything else. So I just want you to know that you have more worth than you think you do. And usually, when people are thrust into my domain, it usually means that they're having some confidence issues. You know, be proud like a lion, all that stuff. My mantra, what can I say? And be careful in these woods. Obviously, we have a lot of crazy mythological monsters wandering around, so I'm glad you didn't get eaten before. I want to make sure that you are all right, and I want to make sure that if there's anything in my power that can help you, that I go ahead and do that for you. How are you feeling? A little better, a little more put together. Wounds are numb. Now, I would like you to spend some time with me, if that's alright. Just a little bit more time with me, so we can better get to know each other. What do you say? Would you like that? If we got to know each other a little better. Maybe had some fun, helped you to loosen up. Maybe even your body as well. Anyway, I apologize for being so abrupt and rude. But what can I say? It's in my nature. Now, before I send you off to the next Zodiac, started.